crimes against public morals, they are enumerated as follows, and its title here are with corresponding provisions of the law there, no? Articles. So what are crimes against public morals? Okay, they are gambling, Article 195, importation, sale, and possession of lottery tickets or advertisements, Article 196, betting in sport contests, Article 197, illegal betting on horse races, Article 198, illegal cockfighting, Article 199, grave scandal, Article 200, immoral doctrines, obscene publications and exhibitions, Article 201, vagrancy and prostitutions, Article 202. Note that this gambling, importation, betting, sports contest, illegal beating, horse races, illegal cat fighting are already being repealed, and there's already a law that is on top of it. Na-repeal na ng mga provisions na naroon po'y balaod na nag-substitute ani. The provisions of Article 195 to 199, tuloy, 195 to 199, kutob sa illegal cockfighting of the revised penal code are amended, as well as those of Presidential Decree 483, beating, game fixing or point shaving and machinations in sports contests, and 449, cockfighting law, which are inconsistent with Presidential Decree number 1602, are repealed. So the prevailing law now with respect to these articles is already Presidential Decree 1602. When you talk about Presidential Decree, panahon pa rin ni Marcos, ha? Sa time pa sa si Marcos pa ang President. Now, there's a looming another Marcos to be President of the Philippines. Kasi muda o di, eh. So, yan. Ito yung mga batas na kay Marcos pagaling. Presidential Decree 1602 prescribing stiffer penalties on illegal gambling. Section 1, the following penalties are hereby imposed. The penalty of prision correctional in its medium period or a fine ranging from 1,000 to 6,000 pesos. And in case of recidivism, the penalty of prision mayor in its medium period or a fine ranging from 5,000 to 10,000 pesos shall be imposed upon any person other than those referred to in succeeding subsections who in any manner shall directly or indirectly take part in any illegal or unauthorized activities or games of cockfighting, waiting, high alay. Kaling high alay, kusok kayo sa una, waiting, nana sa Luzon. Wala kayo sa Mindanao. Cockfighting all throughout the Philippines niya. Or horse racing. Horse racing, although legal siya, pero on the size na yung mga beating ba? O ito, naka-illegal ka ng beating niya. To include bookie operations and game fixing, numbers, bingo, and other forms of lotteries. Na yung bingo, illegal na siya kung wala yung pista. Maligal na siya kung na yung pista. Of course, they are not allowed to operate bingo even during fiestas if the barangay captain will not allow it, no? So, only when allowed by the barangay captain shall bingo be legal during fiestas. Karaikros, sabi ng karaikios, pompiang and the like, 7-Eleven and any game using dice, blackjack, lucky 9, poker, and its derivatives. So, ginapangan lang nyo din ang mga sugal, no? Monte, bakarak, kuwaho. But take note ka rin mga monte, bakarak, o lucky 9, blackjack. They're all legal if you are going to go inside kanang casino, gani. Legal casino mo na siya, operated by the government of the Philippines mo na. So legal na siya dira. Pero kana lang po, maka-afford ang mga dula lagi. Bakarak, waho, panggigi, and other games. Paikwi, high and low. Mahjong, domino, and other games using plastic tiles and the like. Slot machines, roll it. So nanasasakwa na sa casino, ha. Pinball and other mechanical contraptions and devices. Dog racing, wala ta dali ang dog racing, no? Ay, countering and dog racing, I think, Australia. Dog racing ang ilangan ko dito sa Australia. Boat racing, car racing, and other forms of races, basketball, boxing, volleyball. Note that these sports are legal, only the betting are illegal, ha? Boxing, volleyball, bowling, ping pong, and other forms of individual or team contests to include game fixing, point shaving, and other machinations, banking or percentage game, or any other game or scheme, whether upon chance or skill, wherein wagers consisting of money, articles of value, or representative of value are at stake or made. Ang bowling, oh, itong uso pa ang bowling sa una, dilapit sa may downtown, dito sa NCCC, sa may Matina. Grabe, mga sugal nila yun, walang pandakpa. But I know that the government knows na naisugal, pero wala yung ginapandakop. Ang nahibalaan ako, ginadakop ka ng mga madjong dyan sa mga balay-balay. Kung may magmadjong dara, kung may balaan, pwede na i-raid diha sa mga polis. Any person who shall knowingly permit any form of gambling referred to in the preceding subparagraph to be carried on in an uninhabited or uninhabited place or in any building, vessel, or other means of transportation owned or controlled by him, if the place where gambling is carried on has a reputation of a gambling place, or that prohibited gambling is frequently carried on therein, or the place is a public or government building or barangay hall, the malefactor shall be punished by presyon correctional in its maximum period and a fine of 6,000 pesos. The penalty of presyon correctional in its maximum period or a fine of 6,000 pesos shall be imposed upon the maintainer or conductor of the above gambling schemes. Maintainer or conductor ad mas taas ang ilang penalty. The penalty of presyon mayor in its medium period with temporary absolute disqualification. Pag mention na ganyan temporary absolute disqualification, it should be the ang guilty ani, ang person who committed the crime could be a public officer or employee. Or a fine of 6,000 pesos shall be imposed if the maintainer, conductor, or banker of said gambling schemes is a government official, or where such government official is the player, promoter, referee, umpire, judge, or coach in case of game fixing, point shaving, and machination. The penalty of presyon correctional is medium period or a fine ranging from 400 to 2,000 pesos shall be imposed upon any person who shall knowingly and without lawful purpose in any hour of the day possess any lottery, list, paper, or other matter containing letters, figures, signs, or symbols pertaining to or in any manner used in the games of waiting, high alay, or horse racing bookies, and similar games of lotteries and numbers which have taken place or about to take place. So, gimension din rin ako na, gimension ang waiting, high alay, or horse racing bookies. Ang wala gimension din rin ang last quarters na kanang mga games gani. Pero nasulot na siya sa similar games of lotteries and numbers which have taken place or about to take place. So, all-encompassing ni siya nga paragraph, although gimension ang uban, but katong uban wala ma-appeal, nasulot rin sa unsimilar games of lotteries. The penalty of temporary absolute disqualification shall be imposed upon any barangay official who with knowledge of the existence of a gambling house or place in his jurisdiction fails to abate meaning ipugnan ba, or to control the same or take action in connection therewith. The penalty of presyon correctional in its maximum period or a fine ranging from 500 pesos to 2,000 pesos shall be imposed upon any security officer, security guard, watchman, private or house detective of hotels, villages, buildings, enclosures, and the like, which have the reputation of a gambling place or where gambling activities are held. So, repealing clause, provisions of Article 195, girepeal na niya itong Article 195 up to 199 sa Revised Penal Code. Pati Republic Act Number 3063, Presidential Decree 483, 449, 519, and 1306. Effectivity, took effect immediately upon publication, but this once in a newspaper in general circulation. We don't know kailan ito na-publish, but it was done in 11th day of June in the year of the Lord 1978. So during 1978, isaina ni Ferdinand E. Marcos, President of the Philippines. So what is gambling? Gambling is any game or scheme, whether chance or skill. Chance kana ganing tagna-tagna. Sa una sa high school pa mi, ma-remember na ako ako mga classmate magkuan ba kanang mag-wager, pustaanay. Pustaanay gyud, sinsilyo ra gyud noon. Kana ganing makadungog og naay maabot nga bus. Bus, maabot na bus diya sa school, mulabay man lang sa school. O niya, tagnaon unsay number, unsay last two digits number. Haod kay itong isang classmate na ako, sige siya kadaog. Eh, di siya kadaog, kay memorizon man niya ang sound sa bus. Pamilya sa sound sa bus, nagin siya abilidad ba? Pag pamilya sa sound sa bus, balaan niya unsay last two digits sa number sa bus. Ang kadaog siya, posta mi sa yan, may kadaog, eh, kuya, okay, abilidad. Remember na ako siya. How kayo? Anyway, Presidential Decree No. 1602 dated June 11, 1978 provides stiffer penalties for violations of the gambling laws. So take note, nag-mention ang mga gambling activities na nag-mention, particularly chance or skill. Ang skill, karang-karing, siyempre, dula, basketball, bowling, ping-pong, kasi yung kadaog pustaan ay, kasi yung kadaog na ay pusta. Walang problema, ang game itself is legal. But the betting around, that's illegal. No? Kasi itong mga pustaan ay mo na ang illegal dira. So, dimension, cockfighting. Kaning cockfighting, actually, legal man din siya kung dito i-conduct dito sa conjured, sa main nga kanang cockfighting arena. God. Every town, nagin na siya. Ikin mo wala na yung kwan. Sabungan. Waiting. So, waiting, wala ta kayo familiarization ani. Nani sa Luzon, mangon siya. Ang waiting. Hay Alay. Kanin sa, although ang kanin Hay Alay, sa Manila na siya ginadula. Anong nai, Hay Alay nga games na ginadula. Nai, game fixing, yapo na ana. Sikat kanina sa una panahon, sa panahon ni Marcos. Natula pa na Juan si Marcos na kick out sa Pilipinas. Si Kata ni Hay Alay, oy. Basta, naghanang mamatad ni Hay Alay. Naghang kayo mga magkwa, naghang kayo mga materialis para mag-predict kung sa'yo sulod ng mugawas ng numero. Last three digits, last three numbers mo na. Last three numbers mo na ang mugawas sana. I mean, a number sa player 1 to 10. 1 to 10 yata. 1 to 9. O sa number, kisa itong naikuha mo na siya kanang every ay category, every game na magdaog. Kisa itong mudaog, ana, mo itong combination ato, kisa yung kadaog sa Toluca Games, combine ang mga numbers nila, mo na ang magawas ng resulta, mo na ang tayaan mo. Say 1 to 9, ana, mo na ang tayaan. 9, say una ba? 10 siguro to. Kalimot ko 10. 10 biyata to. 9 na po to. 10, 5, 3. Ana, muna ang tayaan nila. Nataya-taya po kung sa una. Mara ka ng exciting ba? Kaya maka-predict mo ka, pwede hindi mo ma-himuan ng statistics ang magawas ng numero. Pagka-familiar ana ng number game sa una. Hay Alay. Horse racing, wala kahit ada rin, no? Bingo na, bingo. Other forms of lotteries, kanan mga halasto, last three. Kara i-cross, kanan kara i-cross, muna siya yung kuhin, hantak ni, no? Tama ko, guys. Kara i-cross, hantak ni. Tell me if I'm wrong. Kara i-cross. Kara is face. Cross is sa likod, gani. Pumpya and the like. 7-11, walang ko balo, ano yung 7-11? Murag kuhin siya, kanang i-rule ni mo ang dice, 7-11. Blackjack, kaya barahan eh. Lucky 9, poker, and its derivatives, mga cards ni siya. Monte, Baccarat, Wahoo, Pangigi, and other card games. Paikwe, High and Low, Mahjong, Domino. Kana na siya ay plastic tiles na ilabay ni mo sa kanang kwan. Plastic tiles kanang bato. Bula gani nga kwan, lingin. Butang ni mo sa... Butaan mo sa murag ka ng sandayong, tapos hulog siya dito, namamili siya, unsay number siya mo hunong. Kaya siya mga kwan, paki high and low. Mahjong, kanyang mga tiles na sa kwan, domino, lahat po na domino. Kanim domino kabaluan, pero kanam madjong, magisod ko kabaluan. Daghan ng adakpan sa Davao, kanang mga nagadulag madjong for illegal gambling. Daghan po na adakpan sa Davao, kanang last two. Kanang mga pobre lang ko, nang mamaligyang last two, para lang panginabuhay nila. Nawa na panginabuhay tao, kay dakpan man, abot dito sa korte, pabayaron o 1,000 lang ganyan, musungkuhan lang ka, mupli guilty lang ka, bayaron ka 1,000, pero di na ka pwede maka-utro, kaya kung utro ka pa, prison na yun ka next time around. No? Slot machines, roll it, pinball and other mechanical contraptions and devices, kaya na mga jackpot-jackpot, nahanan niya sa sukuan, sa casino niya, dog racing, boat racing, car racing, and other forms of races. Volleyball, boxing, volleyball, basketball, boxing, volleyball, bowling, ping pong, and other forms of individual or team contests to include game fixing, point shaving, and other machination. Banking or percentage game, or other game or scheme whether upon chance or skill, wherein wagers consisting of money, articles of value, or representative of value are at stake or made. So take note of these penalties of those particular gambling activities. So after 9... after Republic Act 1602, nana po yung bago, no, increase of penalties sa katong mga ipang-istoryahan nga illegal numbers game. Republic Act 9287, approved on April 2004, increasing the penalties for illegal numbers game, amending the provisions of Presidential Decree 1602. Then, daghan nagarakpan ug last to, no? Illegal numbers game is any form of illegal gambling activity which uses numbers or combinations thereof as factors in giving out jackpots, prizes, returns. It includes games such as waiting, mashaw, and lasto. Gimension na gito rin ang lasto, mashaw. Mashaw, muna to itong kwan, itong high alay. Mashaw high alay yung mana. Mana siya, lahay na po ng pangalan, pero pareha na siya, mashaw high alay. Any person who participates in any illegal numbers game shall suffer the following penalties. Imprisonment from 30 to 90 days if person acts as bettor. Mapustahay lang ka 30 to 90 days, so 1 month to 3 months. Imprisonment from 6 years and 1 day to 8 years if person acts as personnel or staff of an illegal numbers game. Mga last to usher. Oh? Or allows his vehicle, house, building, or land to be used in such operation. Oh? Operator na ginagin siya, no? Imprisonment from 8 years and 1 day to 10 years if person acts as collector or agent. So, mas tako. Imprisonment from 10 years and 1 day to 12 years if person acts as coordinator, controller, or supervisor. Imprisonment from 12 years and 1 day to 14 years if person acts as maintainer, manager, or operator. Imprisonment from 14 years and 1 day to 16 years if person acts as financier or capitalist. Imprisonment from 16 years and 1 day to 18 years if person acts as financier or cuddler. So, muna siyang mga penalties. Corresponding penalties from mere bitor to illegal staff personnel to collector, controller, manager, capitalist, and cuddler. Now, if collector, agent, controller, supervisor, maintainer, manager, operator, financier, or capitalist of any illegal numbers game is a government employee and or public official, whether elected or appointed, he shall suffer the penalty of 12 years and 1 day to 20 years and a fine ranging from 3 million pesos to 5 million pesos and perpetual absolute disqualification from public office. Taghan kong naibalaan ng mga tao sa gobyerno, ng mga financier, rumor lang po, paano ni ma-approve? Wala kayang problema kung saan yung pag-proof kay ano maglihok diha ng mga usher, collector, nila yung mga mutugan kung kinsa financier nila. Mapapreason na lang siya, plea guilty na lang siya, but as to the information kung kinsa yun ang tao above sa ilahang rank, in regards sa operations sa illegal numbers, wala na kayo makuhaan ng information. So it's very hard to pin down these people na behind the operation of illegal numbers game. Oh? Napadali, any law enforcer who fails to apprehend perpetrators of any illegal numbers game shall suffer an administrative penalty of suspension or dismissal to be imposed by the appropriate authority. So na yung ginatawag nato sa kwan, sa dito na nauso sa Luzon, sa huiting nila, kay rampat niyo kay huiting niya, dili gyud pwede nga ma-prevent ba ngano man na yung mga daghang pulis, daghang mga military. Pero naman na lang gihapon, magpadayon lang gihapon. So ang ginabuhat karon sa mga sa PNP ana sa una time ni kwan ni Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Ang ginabuhat sa PNP na sila ginatawag nga one strike or two strike. So sabot pasabot ani, one strike deal. Sabot pasabot ani. Ang katong police official ana nga lungsod, say the highest police official ana nga lungsod, if he is unable to prevent the proliferation of the illegal numbers game, say waiting in that in their area, kaysa lang badlungon. Ignore lang niya, one strike na ka, di, kung naalang gihapon, di gihapon mawala, wala na, tanggal ka niya sa opisit, sa kwan, sa imong office, and then, pwede ka ibalhin. Balhin naman nila. Di magiging na siya tanggalon, ibalhin lang sa uban nga jurisdiction. Pero wala na siya diya sa poder, dili na siya makapangwarta. Mamupugod na yung protection racket good sa mga police diya, sa kanang mga illegal numbers. So, the moment na irampant niya illegal numbers, sigurado na yung police nga behind ana, may protector na siya. And then kisa mapimutukan yung protector siya. So there's no way that this particular police could be punished being a protector. But nonetheless, moto ang katong stiff orders nila sa una. One strike and you're out. Ana lang, ana ang PNP official. Katong mga chief of police lagi sa lungsod, tanggal rin so pag yun wala napigyapon mo ang illegal numbers game diya, tanggal ka na. So why gambling is prohibited and punished? Ay, to repress an evil that undermines the social, moral and economic growth of the nation. Kabalo ka sa environment, sa isa pamilya, ang tension na nasa pamilya, whenever one member of the family is a gambler, addict gambler, gambling addict, malo ka sa tension na grabe, sira ang pamilya to the point na tanang mga butang pwede mabaligya at tanang mga tao din sa sulod magpanagana sa ibutang ilang kwarta kay tao-tao na buwala yun, kawato na sa iyang kapamilya nga suga pa sa sugal. So that's the moral fiber there kung addict ka na sa sugal. Dili man mo na siya addict na physically addict ka, there is a psychological thing involving it, no? Para bang drone ka na nito that whenever you cannot do that particular gambling activity, you will be a loss on what to do in life. You will be feeling so weak. You will be inactive. You will be mentally lazy. Ano ba? So, alive na yung mga tawanan na kung nasa sa pasugalan. And the adrenaline rush of it, whenever they're expecting that they will win, and but then suddenly after the end of the day, they have lost more than they have won in that particular gambling activities that they are into. Nana kasira ang buhay sa mga tao kung sugarol ka. So take note of that ha. Whenever ako sa una, bata pa ko, grabe ito sa una, ay kuhaon ako, mangko na lang yung kuha, anak ko kakuhaan sa una, although nakarealize ko afterwards, basta kuhaon lang ginakong alkansya sa kumama, doon ako alkansya para makahantak lang ko sa gawas. I was so young then, but I feel the addiction engulfing into me when I was doing such activities. Kay ang adrenaline rush you experience really, experience ko yun na, I don't know kung at what particular point of time that I was able to overcome that addiction. Kay sa pagkarang kung mag-addict mo ka, mapusta ka, it is as if this is your life. Your life is nothing without these particular activities. Parang ganun ba? So you are drawn to it psychologically. And it's very hard for that person if psychologically addicted in gambling to get out of it without any help from psychologists or psychiatrists. But sa ako ang in my case, bata pa man ko ato sa una and nakoy kuan ba, nakoy ka ng pangarap sa kinabuhi gani. So I realized that well, doing that particular gambling would wreck my life and I could not go on further, I could not improve my life in a way. So maybe I changed along the way, coupled with the help of the family na nakasupport, encouraging me to do well in school. Parang ganun, God. So once na yung ma-encourage sa imuha, ma-focus sa imuhang mind dito sa pangarap ni mo, kay ganahan ka, gina-praise ka sa mga tao eh. You are being encouraged and praised that you have achieved so much. And so you focus your mental activity, you focus your energy to the objective of improving your lot rather than indulging yourself to gambling activities. So somehow, na-overcome na to, and I was so glad I did. Pero nakoy ko na, nakoy sa akong gambling habits sa una, nalakoy mental arithmetic. How na kayo ko sa mental arithmetic ato, bata pa ko, and then I could already make some projections, interpolate na ko ang numbers para I could come up with some kind of projection, and I would bet on that number, parang ganun. I had even been able to win number game twice in 2 weeks. In 2 weeks time sa kunsun man to. Twice, last two ganito. Ato sa una, di na ako bata, bro. Kalits may yata ako ato. Bro, nagka-bright sa sugal ba? But, dili na siya impulsive sugal para sa una, sa bata pa ako, suga pa ako. This time, kanang kuha na ako ato, kanang murag reserved ako. In a way, murag nana ko yung reservation to go well into it. Ay nana ko yung protektahan ato nga performance sa ako ang achievement ato sa una while I was in college already. So, gambling is an act beyond the pale of good morals which for the welfare of the people should be exterminated. It has the effect of causing poverty, dishonesty, fraud, deceit. Many men have neglected their business and mortgaged their integrity to follow the fickle goddess of the cards. Many women have wasted their hours and squandered their substance at the gambling board while some children were forgotten. You see? Kita ninyo, pati Supreme Court naka-evaluate ani, and they are able to see the picture of how troubling it is when some persons in the community are gambling addict. Must any and all games mentioned in Presidential Decree Number 1602 be played for money? So it was held that the playing of Monte for money is not a necessary element. It seems that when the law names the games punishing any person who take part therein, its purpose is to prohibit absolutely those games. Not necessarily when there's a wager for money, but the act of playing it whenever it is illegal is punishable. Any other game or scheme, whether upon chance or skill, so PD 1602 portion of your off makes a game or scheme punishable even if the winning depends upon skill, when wagers consisting of money, articles or value or representative of value are at stake or made. As regards the games of individual or team contests, like boxing or basketball, game fixing, point shaving and other machinations is also penalized. I don't know the technicalities of game fixing, but this is actually in coordination with the person giving you some kind of reward whenever you would agree to whatever you would do in the game itself, like on basketball. And you have been known to have a skill of 3-point shooter, and every time you throw the ball at 3 points distance, you could really get a shot. Now, here comes a person who would give you some kind of reward. Say, I will give you 500,000 pesos. Just don't shoot your ball 3 times. Parang ganon. That's game fixing in a way. No? Don't shoot 3 times successive. Eh, tukato lang. Shoot, dili lang. So, nani postahan na dito sa sides diyan. Nani postahan na sa sides. Kada itsa niya, ma-shoot niya dili. Maraming nana ba? So that's how they fix game sa basketball. Point shaving din na kayo ko familiar ani, other machinations. So you see guys, this is how to get rich in gambling as regards basketball. If you have money enough to capitalize on it, no? All you have to do is just fix the game and have a coordinate, help or be in coordinate in coordination with the player inside, no? Kato imong ginakuan din. Or even the team itself, the team, mga hawag kayo, and the team is supposed to win the championship. And then, mingon lang siya, may lang itong tao dito, coach, ayaw pa dauga yung team run. Na may premium sa mga. That's how to fix the game, no? Game fixing yun actually. So, at any rate, katong nagsugod sa imuha, nagapusta na to sila. Sila gipustahan. Kadaog na to sa pustahan na eh. So, kung dili kadaog, dili ma-champion ang team, lugi. Dili gito ma-champion, pero naapo sila yung mga kwarta. Specifically, the coach and the top-notch players there involved in the game fixing. Spectators are not liable in gambling. A mere bystander or spectator in a gambling game is not criminally liable because he does not take part therein, directly or indirectly. The law does not make the mere presence in gambling house an offense. I had one case involving a security guard. Ito to sa iya, ha? I don't know if na-convict na to siya. Niagi lang siya dito sa may hantakan. Hantakan is kanang naibato gani. Tapos maghantak at tulog ka sensilyo. Hantak-hantak. Tapok mga tao. Niagi lang siya gikan sa duty. Tapos, tantood na siya na tanaw dito. I don't know kung nipatad ba siya. But then, tantood na siya dito. Nagbibo na kayo. Ang hantak-hantak. Pinustahan na dito. Nilabergon siya. Giraid pa ng police karon, pati siya dakpan, pati tong bato dala, tong sensilyo na dito dala, isibit sa police. At siya mismo, security guard, siya ang principal dito, nagipailag kaso sa illegal gambling. Palagi yung may kasagang ato, in a way, even if our defense is to that he was only a mere bystander. Kasi, murag na nakuha yata sa iyang position ang katong mapamato gani sa hantak. Amato ka itong mga tulong ka coins. Pero dito na kuha, siguro na involved siya kahantak dito, pinapil po siya kahantak, tabtan siya, dito na kuha. So nakuha yun. So, ang police man po mo, testify man po ang police nga, siya yun, rock pa lang mo, siya yun ang una-una dito. But anyway, despite my client saying that he was just merely a spectator, bystander, nilabay lang dito. Even if how much I could believe him, but the evidence says otherwise. So what you could aim mo? Nagpa-probation lang miyato sa iya. So what is lottery? It is a scheme for the distribution of prizes by chance among persons who have paid or agreed to pay a valuable consideration for a chance to obtain a prize. So, sama na ang lottery element, consideration, chance, price, or some advantage or inequality in amount or value which is in the nature of a prize. Lottery embraces all schemes for distribution of prizes by chance. If the scheme is such that human reason, foresight, sagacity, or design cannot enable one to know or determine the result until the same has been accomplished, then it is lottery. Even guessing competition constitutes lottery. The LD Batty, the newspaper published an announcement that it was awarding prizes aggregating 18,000 pesos to the winners in two guessing contests. For the nearest approximate guesses as to the total number of votes that will be cast for any of the winning candidates for Carnival Queen in the provinces or in Manila. Or for the nearest approximate guesses as to the total number of votes that the Queen elect will receive for the Carnival Queenship. To enter the contest, one must subscribe to the El Debate newspaper. Hell, there was a lottery. The argument that there was no consideration for the reason that each subscriber to the El Debate received the full value of his money by receiving the paper every day for the period he subscribed is tenable only as respect those persons who would subscribe to the paper regardless of the inducement to win prize. The position is fallacious. As to other persons who subscribe merely to win a prize. So, para lang makadaw kang prize, ni-subscribe ka. Pero katong ni-subscribe yun, para mabasa lang sa newspaper, wala to sila ilabot. No lottery where there is full value of money. The accused advertised that 500 packages of cigarettes would be sold at 30 centavos a package. It's regular price. In one of the packages was a coupon. The person fortunate enough to buy that package with coupon could be entitled to a good gold watch. Held not a lottery. The player obtains full value for his money, the winning of the watch. A mere incident. You take note of it. So knowingly permitting gambling to be carried on in a place owned by or controlled by the offender also is punishable. Maintainer or conductor in gambling game or scheme is also punished. Maintainer is the person who sets up and furnishes the means with which to carry on the gambling game or scheme. Conductor is the person who manages or carries on the gambling game or scheme. Article 195, what acts are punishable in gambling? The penalty of arresto minor or fine not exceeding 200 pesos. As I said, na repeal na siya. In case of recidivism, the penalty of arresto mayor or fine ranging from 200 to 6,000 pesos shall be imposed upon any person other than those referred to in subsection C. Well, Monty, i-mention na siya, na-repeal na siya. Article 196, also importation, sale, and possession of lottery tickets or advertisements is also being repealed. No? Now, let's go to the betting in sports contest. Repealed na siya by Presidential Decree No. 483. Betting money or any object or article of value or representative of value upon the result of any game, races, or other sports contest. Game fixing, any arrangement, combination, scheme, or agreement by which the result of any game, races, or sports contest shall be predicted and or knows other than on the basis of the honest playing skill or ability of the players or participants. And then, and I say definition that's a game fixing. Point shaving. Tanawa na yung point shaving. Any such arrangement, combination, scheme, or agreement by which the skill or ability of any player or participant in a game, races, or sports contests to make points or scores shall be limited deliberately in order to influence the result thereof in favor of one or the other team, player, or participant therein. Ano siya ang game, a point shaving, no? Point shaving. Game machination, any other fraudulent, deceitful, unfair, or dishonest means, method, manner, or practice employed for the purpose of influencing the result of any game, races, or sports contest. So betting, game fixing, point shaving, or game machination, they're all unlawful and they're punishable. So, nag-mention rin yung kanyang volleyball, softball, boxing bouts, high alay, or pilota. High alay, pilota. Muna ang game, pilota actually. High alay, matong masyaw. Ano, other sports contests, games or races, as well as betting therein, except as may be authorized by law, is hereby declared unlawful. So, once unlawful, it has to be punished. And the penalty are stated in section 3, no? Penalty. So take note of that. Illegal betting on horse racing races. So this 198 is also being repealed, no? So mga horse races, pwede siya. Pero na yung mga races, ka dili pwede sa in times of the year. July 4th of each year, dili pwede ang horse racing. December 30th of each year, any registration or voting days, election siya. Wala pwede racing dali. Holy Thursday and Good Friday, dili pwede ang racing. Illegal cockfighting, and this is repealed by Presidential Decree No. 449, Cockfighting Law of 1974. Cockfighting shall embrace any mean, unmean the commonly known game or term cockfighting, derby, pintakasi, or tupada, or its equivalent term in different Philippine localities. Karon sa ang kanang cockfighting na sila ibang ong term na podron. So ganyan ang term kanang mapapatad ka. Online sabong gani. Pero na sila term ana kanang mapatad sa iyo. Mapatad gani sa online sabong. Galog ba to? Sakla sa to? Takla? Ano? Salpakan yan. Salpakan. Muna na ang term. Wala na yung appeal din sa mga balaod ha. Pero karon ang gawas na nga term. Salpak na. Salpak tayo. Salpakan. Isa ba yung nakapatayan o kanang online sabong nari sa inyo ha? Yan. Remember ko na term salpakan, line sabong na siya term. Anyway, so cockfighting sa embrace of zoning law or ordinance either or both national or local city or municipal legislation which logically arranges, prescribes, defines, and apportions a given political subdivisions into specific land uses as present and future projection needs warrant. Betaker or promoter, a person who calls and takes care of bets from owners of both game cocks and those of other bettors before he orders commencement to the cockfight and thereafter distributes won bets to the winners after deducting a certain commission. Kasi tawag nyo ani? Ani bet taker or promoter? Sabay nagasunod o sabungan diri. Ay tawag ani? Kuhan pa kayo ang tawag ani? Murag ka ng holy pa kayo ang tawag. Holy ang tawag. Nasa tawag yun. Yes! Kristo! Kabalog yun si Kwanda. Kristo ang tawag ay nila. Isang kabalo. Manabungay na ikaw ha. Ito to nag-answer si Arby. Kristo ang tawag. See? At least if you are familiar with the terms, you will be able to really picture out the activities there, you know, sa ginabuhat nila. Pilip ko ano yung mga Kristo ba kay, di ba? Sa kadaghan sa tao, nagpalibot sa iya, nang kuha sa bet kaya isa sa ila. Madawag mapildi, labay na niya yung kwarta, kabalo sa asa iyan labayan. Palibot, 360 degree labayan nila. Di ba yung mong sipyat? O, kasi sipyat siya ba? Grabe ang mental kwa niya, ha? Imagination, I mean, capacity to memorize the names and the face of the person of whom he got a bit into. Ikaw, kwarto, siko, opa, manana na siya. Sinya si ikaw, ikaw, tululan niya. Pagkahuman sa sabog, labay lang niya. Kwartaw, wow, opa, kulikta lang siya kwarta. Ikaw, may pildi ka, ikaw, daw ko ka. Ano lang ang nitabo ba? So, believe ka sa Kristo, bisang pag mga way grado ng ubandira, pero grabe yung mga kwan, mental capacity to memorize. So, mga Kristo na siya. Gaffer, taga, tari, a person eligible in the art of arming fighting cocks with gaff or gaps in either of both or both legs. Kasagaran sa taga, tari na yung tawag. Kasagaran sa tari, isa lang man yun, diliman duha katil, isa lang na siya. Tapos, ay, napoy mga ubat, tikasan ng mga tigtaga, tigtao, tari. May gusto siya mong pildi na siya, lain ang pagposisyon niya sa taga, sa tari, para pag-strike niya, dili kaigo. Ang katuisa, gwapo pag-strike, igo na yun. So, napay mga skills ana nga katong tigtaga na ang kabalo. Referee, sentensyador. Kanang referee, mo lang nasa tunga yun, mo itong mugunit sa ulo o kanang sa balihibo sa mga manok. Yaain lang, kung sabay, lungoy na ana. Ilungoy na nila ito kung otikaryo. Kung kitsay motosik, isa dili ang motosik, motoy asa niya, motoy nakadaog, ano ba? So, manating sentensyador, no? A person who watches and oversees the proper gaffing of fighting cocks determines the physical condition of fighting cocks while cockfighting is in process, the injuries sustained by the cocks and their capability to continue fighting and decides and make known his decision by word or gestures, the result of the cockfighting by announcing the winner or declaring a tie or no contest game. Betor, a person of participate, of course, no? Itong nagpusta mo, itong mga betor. Anyway, so just read the rest of the cockfighting law. Ah. Now let's go to another provisions of revised penal code. Grave scandal, immoral doctrines, obscene publication, exhibitions, and vagrancy and prostitutions. 200, Article 200, grave scandal. The penalties of arresto, mayor, and public censure shall be imposed upon any person who shall offend against decency or good customs by any highly scandalous conduct not expressly falling within any other article of this code. Kung sama, example aning grave scandal, kanang buoni mo yung mga pantalon, yung mong brief, ituwat-tuwat ka, pakita din mo lumot niya sa public, that's grave scandal, no? Or maghubo ka mismo, sayo-sayo, kinsabay din mo, scandal na, no? Yan ang example sa grave scandal. The offender performs an act or acts that such acts be highly scandalous as offending against decency or good customs. Ano mga buwang? Wala na sila. Exempted na sila sa crime. Kabalo, bida ka na. Nagyan na ninyo, no? The person who is insane is exempted from crime. Wala na sila kabalo kung sa'yo ginabuhat. Anyway, grave scandal consists of acts which are offensive to decency and good customs, which having been committed publicly have given rise to public scandal to persons who have accidentally witness the same. So, makita tayo example sa scandal, ha? Acts of lasciviousness, even if committed publicly, the offender should not be prosecuted and punished under this article. Ay, lahat mong ganun siya, acts of lasciviousness is private naman siya crime. Where the accused scattered coconut remnants with human excrements on the stairs, doors, floor of the balcony of a public elementary school, it was held that the crime was other mischiefs under a delicious grave scandal. The highly scandalous conduct, no? A married woman who habitually appeared in public places with her paramour, frequented suspicious places, vacant houses, did not violate this article because the acts were not committed in public places or within the public knowledge. The crime consists of offensive to decency and good custom, which having been committed publicly have given rise to public scandals. So, sa may mga example, ani, that's when the act complained of was committed at night, in a private house and at a time when no one was present except the accused, the mistress of the house, and one servant, these circumstances do not constitute the degree of publicly a publicity which is an essential element of crime. Wala siya ikan. Puros mga negative man nga ako, Andre. Basta, itong example na ito, katong maghubo lagi siya, diya, mo na pinaka-example. Rape scandal, dyan siya. Immoral doctrines, obscene publication, Article 201, and exhibitions and indecent shows, the penalty of prison, mayor, or a fine ranging from 6,000 to 12,000 pesos or both. Such imprisonment and fine shall be imposed upon those who shall publicly expound or proclaim doctrines openly contrary to public morals. Like, dali na mo sa atong religion, sa among religion, ginapapala kita sa Diyos. Ang musulod rin, pwede lima, duha, tulo, lima asawa. Pwede duha, tulo, lima bana. And then, free for all, tadri. Tanan, we love each other. Siganahan mga nga religion. Isa yung puta pa ng religion sa musulod. Try na ito, di ba mo malakpan. The authors of obscene literature publish with their knowledge in any form the editors publishing such literature and owners, operators of the establishment selling the same. So concerning public kanang mga doctrine ba nga wala dili common and then pagpaintay sa mga tao nga hey, mention nato dari so in theaters, fairs, cinematographs or any other place exhibit indecent or immoral place since acts or shows it being understood that the obscene literature or indecent or immoral place scenes or acts or shows whether live or in film, which are proscribed by virtue thereof, shall include those which glorify criminals or condone crimes, serve no other purpose but to satisfy the market for violence, lust, or pornography, offend any race or religion, tend to abet traffic in and use of prohibited drugs, and are contrary to law, public order, morals, good customs, established policies, lawful orders, decrease and index. But all these things, no, kanyang mga publication, whatever, ipandakop ni siya actually, kunay mga, basa tong bandera sa una, anong bandera ng newspaper sa una, tabloid, grabe ka, kuyaw kayo ng mga, kwan, mga articles dira. Basa din mo, taut-taut, di na ganahan mo buhi, kay ganahan na ka tuloy-tuloy basa. kay mga, kwan naman kayo, kanang, pagbasa pa lang nimo muinit naman ka na gani hitabo so kana gipad nakop na but wala na na it fails so whatever it fails kada mga publications nila mga comics mga whatever magazines Playboy magazine Pin Shop magazine sa una wala it fails to what it is now nga dili siya regulated internet karon na proliferate ang internet anybody including children can see pornography in the internet without any control without any limitations. So katong mga newspapers, magazines, publications, wala ato, wala ra sa kuminking to sila karon sa internet na, because at any time pwede ka magtan-aw og pornography sa internet actually. So kani magdisod na tag although nagya pa yung ginadakop like katong mga tago-tago ng mga kuan masakpan ra yung gyapon, madakpan lang gyapon na sila. Pero sa internet, lisod kayo sila kung ano, lisod kayo i-control. And even if madakpan mo ang internet, mapugnan mo ang site, you cannot pinpoint the persons kisa nag-operate ana because most likely, the operators of this webpage are located outside the Philippines. So, kisa may dakpunin mo nito na sa outside the Philippines ang operator sa webpage. Those who shall sell, give away, or exhibit films, prints, engravings, sculptures, or literatures which are offensive to morals. Okay. Ano siya ang mga bawal? Maligya ka, engravings, sculptures, offensive to morals. So the offense in any of the forms mentioned in the articles is committed only when there is publicity. Karon sa internet, it's actually published na natan eh. Once it is found in the net, it is published. No? Published na siya. And the element of publicity is there. All you have to do is pinpoint the person. If he is inside the Philippines, pinpoint him and charge him accordingly. The word moral implies conformity with the generally accepted standards of goodness or rightness. in conduct or character, sometimes specifically to sexual conduct. So mo na siya kasagaran nga quotation kung mag-istorya tag moral, no? Sexual conduct. Obscene literature is not punished, but the author is liable if it is published with his knowledge. In every case, the editor publishing it is liable. So, a test of obscenity. Test is whether the tendency of the matter charged as obscene is to deprave or corrupt those, okay, whose minds are open to such immoral influences, and to whose hands such publication may fall, and also whether or not such publication or acts shocks the ordinary and common sense of men as an indecency. Indecency is an act against the good behavior and a just delicacy. Well, take to the person doing masturbation. If it is done in public, that is indecent. But if you do it in the bedroom, in the CR where you are the only one without any person watching you, how could that be considered indecent, no? It's really up to the person, no? Kung imo na siya i-publish, imo ipakita, exhibit nimo, that act, sexual act, could now be considered indecent. But when you do it in the privacy of your room, well, everybody, every man has natural needs to attend to, no? Ang punta da, ana, para kay kwa man na, kanang natural cravings man sa tao, di man po pwede mabuhay ang tao wala na, kanang mabutanga. But practicing those things will only be indecent if it is shown, it is exhibited, it is being published. It may be considered that nudity itself is not inherently indecent or obscene. Mere nudity in painting or sculpture is not obscenity as they may be considered pieces of art. But the artistic, the aesthetic, and the pulchritude in the nude body of a living woman may readily be transformed into an indecent and obscene object by posture and movements of such body, which produce perceptible and discernible reaction in the public or audience witnessing the same. No. Well, I don't know how you would discuss this, but ingon dere basta maghukas lang ka, dili na siya indecent. But when you do something that will entice the public to really be, well, become hot, that one would now be indecent because they are now reaching out to your imagination. So momang yung purpose ara, naghubo gari na siya para ma-arouse sa imo imagination to do something for your own self-gratification. Parang ganun ba? Dito sa vagrants and prostitutes penalty. The following are vagrants. Last na lang, ha. Any person having no apparent means of subsistence. Kanang maglakaw-lakaw magabi, ginadakop na siya, who has the physical ability to work and who neglects to apply himself or herself to some lawful calling. Kanang mga nagpalimos sa daplis kalsada nga wala defect, dilipiang, dilibuta, basta lang, wala lang siya ilis, pero wala lang pasabot nga na siya defect. Palimos na. Mga vagrant na klaro, no? Wala yung mga trabaho. Any person found loitering about public or semi-public buildings or places, or tramping or wandering about the country or the streets without visible means of support. Any idle or dissolute person who lodges in houses of ill fame, ruffians or pimps, and those who habitually associate with prostitutes. Any person who not being included in the provisions of other articles of this code shall be found loitering in any uninhabited or uninhabited place belonging to another without any lawful or justifiable purpose. Prostitutes, for the purpose of this article, women who for money or profit habitually indulge in sexual intercourse or lascivious conduct. Sexual intercourse, kana nagyo na penetration, no? Lascivious conduct, kanalang hikap-hikap na, quote-quote, are deemed to be prostitutes. Pero of course, tayo bayad. Hikap-hikap, quote-quote, mabayaron, pugka, no? Any person found guilty of any of the offenses covered by this article shall be punished by arresto minor or fined exceeding 200 pesos. Gamay lang, pero kaya 200 pesos, 40,000 pesos na nikaroon siya. In case of recidivism by arresto mayor, in its medium period to prison correctional in its minimum or period, or a fine ranging from 200 to 2,000 pesos or both in the discretion of the court. You just read the rest of the annotations, no, concerning vagrant prostitutes, and then read Republic Act 9208, the Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act. Trafficking in persons, kanagang imong kidnap po nimo, tapos nato nimo sa imong lugar, instead na patrabahoon, imo ni siyang prostitutes. That's trafficking, no? or any person nga permisa nimo trabaho, nga na ang trabaho, na ang sweldo, but pag abot dito sa lugar, dili dai mao trabaho, na kalisod, kamay lang sweldo. That's traffic. And of course, you would not have given your consent if you know beforehand that it's not the work that you will actually do whenever you are transferred that place. That's trafficking actually. And dili nang trafficking, kanang voluntary yung consent, kakabalo ka, maugid na. Paabot mo dito sa lugar, maupo na yung trabaho. And then you are conveniently paid of that particular work.